Напевно, сам Майдан це було натхнення. Це коли ти приходиш і там півмільйона киян і інших громадян України з інших міст співають гімн. Коли сотні тисячі, мільйони цих вогнів запалюються на Майдані. Це був веселий, щасливий Майдан, який це був Майдан гідності, свободи, миру.
My apartment became the headquarters because I live in the city center, and firstly we just went there to have a cup of tea to feel more comfortable because it was very cold outside. And after that, and after we decided to work more closely on these issues, and we understood that we need volunteers or we need to organize the whole process 24 hours per day and to organize these shifts. So yeah, I've just said, let's do it in my apartment, and my flatmate wasn't very against it. And yes, so for those months, my apartment was a headquarters for every our initiative, starting from this contact point for legal aid or medicine coordination, or now it's help for IDPs.
For me, I so get used to be on Maidan and to see all the barricades, so I cannot imagine one day they disappear and we come back to normal life, and what is this normal life is looked like. I cannot imagine now, because you live in this struggle, in these emotions. This is a tragedy for you, but this is an inspiration in the same time. And the first thing that you do in the morning, you check your mobile phone, and then you see if Maidan is not smashed, and if there is some threat, you just go to Maidan, or you spend the nights. For example, with my husband, we spent several nights, the very crucial nights when there were threats of attack by Berkut police or something else. We were just going and patrolling Maidan and trying just to be there, because we believe that if there are a lot of people in the night, they will not attack people, they will not beat people, they will not kill people. So we try to, but of course you cannot spend every night on Maidan. It's physically very difficult, especially if you work during the days.
И так далее. То есть, наверное, помогало вот это все время держаться то, что все были при деле. Да, могли помогать, и эта деятельность, возможно, сама по себе стала, наверное, терапевтичной в плане психологической. Хотя иногда наоборот, конечно, было напряжение, которое слишком долго это все длилось, да, и слишком долго каждый варился в вот этих событиях смерти, поиск пропавших, разговоры с родственниками, наверное, это было самое тяжелое.
Very courageous for me was the story when our clique organized a hidden hospital. They have only house which was proposed for them, one charity funds, any equipment. But at the end of the day, they have such equipment which are in the very modern and hospitals. The people gave money for this equipment, and it was unbelievable. The doctor said that they haven't, from the whole time from Nezalezhnosti, from our independence, they haven't such good equipment in their hospitals, which were given them by gift during Euromaidan by people.
Щоранку чи щовечора інколи не було в нас, ми працювали нон-стоп, бували таке, що по дві, по три доби не спала. Я собі завжди казала, якщо не я, то хто? Це відповідальність. Ти її або береш на себе, або не береш. Це відповідальність за майбутнє своєї країни, в якій ти хочеш жити. Бо я не хочу звідси, я не хочу їхати з України нікуди. Це моя відповідальність. Це люди, які стояли на Майдані, бо тому що це була така велика родина. Це Я багато кого з них не знала, але багато з ким потоваришувалась. Це мої друзі, це мої близькі, це мої брати і сестри, які в мене є. Тобто я взяла на себе відповідальність за майбутнє.
Well, there were different feelings, and frankly speaking, I cannot say that all these months I felt myself as human rights defender, because sometimes I just felt myself as a citizen and as a human being. I just went to Maidan and helped to construct a barricade, or I was sitting in occupied Kyiv City Hall, or like, it's not a human rights defender strategy and work, but I worked in the office as a human rights defender, and then I worked in the field as a journalist, and then I just went to the square and stood with some lozenges and slogans and helped to construct barricade as a citizen. So I cannot say that I was split in three or four or many parts that were inside me. And of course, for me as a human rights defender, it was difficult because you cannot see at all the things like put in some wall and without any emotions working with that. All of us were too much emotionally involved in all these events, and it was not easy for me to work with, for example, with the relatives of Berkut, of policemen killed during the events. It was not easy, but we managed to do that.